Toñito sonrió. Toñito smiled. When he and I first met last week, he and his mother had come forward for a blessing at the end of our 1 p.m. Palm Sunday Mass. On that day, his eyes were filled with tears. Lo vi cuando vino a dar reverencia a la cruz, esa sonrisa. Me sorprendió porque recordé sus lágrimas de la semana pasada, cuando los bendecimos, él y a su madre Rosenda, porque se quemó su casa en México por una explosión. We came to know this family here at Holy Rosary from Puerto Palomas, Chihuahua, just over the border from Columbus, New Mexico, because of a grave explosion in their home and their severe injuries, they were airlifted to University Hospital here in Albuquerque. And for their continued recovery and treatment, one of our parishioners, Susie Sarmiento, has been offering them hospitality. Rosenda and Toñito have been journeying with us through all of Holy Week. Si hay alguien aquí que ha participado en esta Semana Santa que puede dar testimonio del poder de los símbolos de la naturaleza, es esta familia. Hoy rodeamos el fuego pascual y celebramos que la luz llena las tinieblas. Pero también vemos con la experiencia de nuestros amigos Toñito y Rosenda el peligro que puede ser el fuego. Y sabemos lo mismo sobre el agua. Es el símbolo de la nueva vida, de purificación y de los dones divinos que nos sostienen. Y también es una fuerza de muerte y sufrimiento. The symbols we encounter tonight, the powerful illuminating presence of fire that can so easily destroy all it touches, the nourishing, saving, refreshment of water that can wipe away all life in an instant. They remind us that we are not somehow apart from the whole of God's creation, that we are not in fact separate authors of our own destinies, but we too are weak, vulnerable, and embedded in a wild world of forces that delicately balance to allow us to continue to live and to love. Estos símbolos dan testimonio de la realidad que celebremos con cenizas cuando empezamos la cuaresma. Que somos pequeños, que somos insignificantes, que no tenemos tanto poder, pero en medio de todo, que somos amados por Dios. Que Dios nos ama porque somos de su creación, de su tierra. Y más que todo, que podemos amar. What we come to celebrate, to encounter tonight, is much more than simply a humbling recognition of our frailty in the midst of the immensity of creation. It is to recognize that there is a freedom in the smallness we came to own as we placed ashes on our foreheads when we entered the holy season of Lent. That we are not diminished to nothing by the union we know in the midst of God's creation, but in fact, we are empowered by it. Sentimos que vivimos sin poder, pero también somos parte de y participamos en el poder del mundo, porque somos parte de la creación. Y más que eso, somos la única parte de la creación que puede decir sí al movimiento de Dios. Sí, es la verdad. No tenemos poder como el fuego o el agua, pero tenemos el poder de responder, de dar respuesta a Dios. Eso es lo que hicieron Rosenda y Toñito y la familia Sarmiento. Que en medio de las realidades fuera de nuestro control, decidieron buscar la esperanza, confiar, esperar y amar. Although it may at times feel that we are just leaves being blown in the wind of creation, the forces of nature, the forces of human frailty and sin and evil pushing against us, although we may feel lost and powerless, that is when we realize that the unique strength we have been given by God has not been our physical strength, but in the power of our will. Although the forces of pain and suffering that have pushed our friends Rosenda and Toñito into our midst this week are great, their desire to continue to live in hope, their willingness to trust in love, and the Sarmientos family and our community's continued willingness to offer a love that can be trusted carry a power much greater than any storm or even the evils of the human condition can overcome. Cuando Toñito sonrió a la cruz, pensé, nuestro poder existe en nosotros mismos por la voluntad. La voluntad que hace el poder de tomar la vida y matar al Salvador del mundo. Dios transforma ese poder a un camino de gracia. El símbolo de pena y sufrimiento cambia a un símbolo de libertad y gracia. Y es lo mismo para cada uno de nosotros. En cada vida, en cada uno de nosotros existe un poder tan grande, el poder de nuestra voluntad de vivir en el amor de Dios. En la gracia de Dios, tenemos el mismo poder de la naturaleza. Tomemos o demos la vida. Como lo experimentamos en el Domingo de Ramos, el corazón humano tiene la capacidad de proclamar, bendito sea el que viene en el nombre del Señor, Hosanna en el cielo. Y un momento cambia a gritar, crucifícalo, crucifícalo. Pero esta noche celebramos que la luz del fuego no nos quema, el consuelo del agua no nos ahoga, sino triunfa el amor. Tonight is the night that we confront not only our profound weakness in the midst of the powers of creation, the powers of our world, the powers of sin, but tonight is the night that we also see and claim the true victory that Christ gives us. Tonight is the night that we see the love extended in the washing of the feet that was poured out upon all through Christ's blood on the cross. That love is in fact what triumphs over all. Triumphs even over the greatest power that we may know, that of death. For in fact, the very path toward death, driven by the fickle human hearts who proclaimed, crucify him, and the instrument of that torture, was overcome by the simple act of love that preceded it all. That the ability for our hearts to be raised in singing God's Hosanna praise indeed holds the last word. Muchas veces nosotros sentimos que estamos en medio de la pasión, que estamos llevando y cargando la cruz, que estamos en medio de esta lucha entre la vida y la muerte. Y por eso sentimos que no hay una esperanza verdadera. No podemos ver la luz, solo sentimos las quemaduras del fuego. O no nos refresca el agua, solo nos ahoga. Pero en las quemaduras está la fuerza de luz que nos guía. En las respiraciones está el agua que nos purifica. En nuestra voluntad que dice sí o no a vivir por amor, antes, durante y después de la pasión, de nuestra propia pasión. El amor existe en medio de gozo y sufrimiento, en los júbilos y las penas, porque el amor es la respuesta de Dios a nuestras debilidades y pecados, y es nuestra propia respuesta a las penas del mundo. Las mujeres del Evangelio eligieron a continuar a amar en medio de su tristeza. Ellas fueron al sepulcro para cuidar al cuerpo de su Señor, y por eso, por su amor, ellas entendieron que Jesús resucitó. Sometimes in our own darkness, it's easy to hear empty platitudes. The resurrection can almost seem like some empty fairy tale where we proclaim that love conquers all, especially when we feel that there is no light to guide us, only fire to singe us, that there's no water to cleanse and cool us, only tempests to sweep us away. And yet that is what brings us to this holy night. To see that the resurrection of Christ is not some quick fix, some simple solve, some platitude that just makes all the struggles of life go away. It is Christ who triumphs over the greatest forces in our lives, that of death, that shows us that we hold a profound power as children of God and as his holy people, to choose each day by which path we can live and move and have our being. And in so doing, we make a choice in each moment to use our power, our will for good, to take a risk in trusting in the wonder that can exist beyond the blinding forces of our pain, to live right now as if, and come to see that in fact, it already is in God's love. We often find the resurrection when we persevere in love, even amidst the struggles of our lives. Like the women who went not in hopes to find Christ risen, but simply to tend to his broken and lifeless body. It was in this act of love, in the midst of hopelessness, that they found hope. Love does not require anything more than our yes to persevere. It is then that we have the power to smile upon the cross, not to run from it. For we know that the greatest encounter of love we will ever know is when we allow God's power to surge through us in what seems to be our weakness, that we may always say yes to being such love. Los sacramentos que celebramos esta noche son las ventanas entre la vida de Dios, entre su amor y misericordia hoy y en este mundo. So when we come to see that in this holy night, we do not flee the torments of the world, but rather we are empowered by God's love that we encounter in his healing sacraments, we come to know and claim him in the midst of all, the terrifying and inspiring power of creation and the humbling capacities of our own hearts. Tenemos el riesgo de amar, de recibir y dar el amor de Dios. Y eso es lo más poderoso del mundo. Más poderoso que las fuerzas de la naturaleza. Más poderoso que la muerte. Let us smile together at the cross, knowing that through it, if we have the courage to share the love we have been given, we come to know and be Christ's light in his resurrection. Sonriemos juntos en las tinieblas. Porque en Cristo somos la luz.